name is Connie Savora Price. I am the Chief Medical Officer at Denver Health, and I'm also an infectious diseases physician.
My name is Anuj Mehta. I am a pulmonary and critical care physician here at Denver Health and assistant professor of medicine.
COVID-19 vaccines are safe and they work.
They've been through really rigorous clinical trials. The safety profile for the vaccines is no different based on age, gender, race, ethnicity, or if you have certain common comorbidities like obesity or diabetes or lung disease. The vaccine is equally safe across these populations.
The whole nation would be doing its part if everyone got vaccination. We could return to normal much more quickly.
We have two vaccines that are available to us immediately. One produced by Pfizer, one produced by Moderna.
Those are mRNA vaccines, and so what that entails is a strand of RNA, which is a type of chemical that's in our own bodies, but this is an RNA that's unique to COVID. It's just a piece of it, so it can't cause the COVID virus. It's not the COVID virus that's in these vaccines, just that's that little piece of instructions on how to make a protein.
Both show about equal efficacy of around 95%. Based on the data we have seen with the two vaccines available to us, there is no concern that one is better than the other.
It's not very painful. It's a good way to protect yourself and protect your loved ones.
It was a race between developing a vaccine and a race between the COVID virus infecting all of us. Thanks to the technology, we were able to accelerate the development. And it has also been shown now in clinical trials involving over 75,000 people with these first two vaccines at least, that it is very safe. And the theory is very sound. Because of the intense collaboration, the orchestration and the timeline and funding given, we were able to achieve this milestone within a year of knowing this virus even existed. Based on the data I have seen to date, I have no reservations about getting this COVID-19 vaccine.
The vaccine, I think, is really critical for our communities of color, and I understand that there's hesitancy and potential distrust in the process, but the clinical trials that were done by the companies included a large number of individuals from a really varied background. And this was done specifically to try and address some of these concerns and history of not including communities of color in research. And I think that what they've done is by creating a very diverse population in our clinical trials, we can speak very specifically about the safety in these different populations. So specifically for communities of color, there is evidence that the vaccine is just as safe and just as effective as it is for everybody else.
I feel good. And I recommend it to other people to do it.
In about a third of people who get the vaccine, you'll experience a reaction. And that's because the vaccine is doing what we want it to do, produce an immune response. You may have arm soreness. You may even have fever. You may feel like you have a headache. Your muscles may ache. It may mimic a mild form of COVID-19 or the flu. It's an inflammatory side effect that just reflects the vaccine is working.
Anybody that's had kind of itching with penicillin or a sulfa drug or has a food allergy to eggs or something should feel safe to get the vaccine. What we do know is everybody needs to be monitored after they get the vaccine for a certain amount of time, and people that have had a serious allergic reaction to, say, a food may want to be monitored for a little bit longer.
It's better to schedule the vaccine before a day off or when you don't have a lot of plans the next day, because you may feel some side effects from it and you'll want to have some time to recover from that. If you are a pregnant woman, if you are breastfeeding, or if you're immunocompromised, right now it's an individual decision that you should make between you and your doctor whether the COVID-19 vaccine is right for you. Once you get the vaccine, we still have to wear our masks. We still have to be mindful of social distancing until we can ensure that the community has herd immunity. So if we achieve a certain percentage of people who have either had COVID-19 or received the vaccine, then we can stop the circulation of the virus. So I see this as the final tool in our toolbox. We have masking, we have social distancing, and now we have a vaccine. I see a way out of this pandemic.
I think the vaccines are a home run.